the scarf. Outfit Boy in Irani, as Irani means orange as well as marigold in Maori, which they thought would represent their garment the best. In addition, they have a male model, which is why they have named it Boy. He's like a fierce warrior down the end there. This is Alex Sue, everybody, modeling this awesome outfit, Boy in Irani. Awesome, thanks, Alex. Okay. Elizabeth and her friends from Otahuhu College have created this unique skirt and top. It features bulbs collected from the Ogawe plant, which only drop these bulbs every 20 years. The clever use of these bulbs and lights show their design skills off. They have managed to incorporate colours by injecting orange peel amongst the plants for highlights. And the model is Dye. I hope I said that right. You can tell me off when you get down the end. The outfit is called From Ground Up. Well done. Good effort. Hidden Oasis is modelled and designed by Zara Cornwell from Selwyn College and is a design which uses products that could be found in a typical New Zealand garden. Weaved flax is used to create the tablecloth look and a garden sacking material has been used for the skirt. There's also dried herbs and plants from the garden which relates to the theme of edibles. The overall design is constructed so the bottom half is the ground with the plants and the top half is the table with a New Zealand twist on a classic tablecloth. Hidden Oasis, everybody, modelled by Zara Cornwell. And this is a Selwyn College edition. Is in the tent. McCartney, your mum would like you out the back, please. So, McCartney, quick smart, out the back. Thank you. Okay, life's a picnic, everybody. And this is Roshni modeling life's a picnic. And this garment is the designers, there's a few of them, the designer's interpretation of Mother Nature. She represents the beauty of growing food and spending time with friends and family at the picnic. The best way to enjoy a meal. It's made with a picnic blanket, some dead ferns, and a collection of different types of rubbish and knickknacks found around the house. Ably accessorized with a wonderful watering can. And an incredible fascinator. Thank you, Roshni. Okay, Queen Bee. This Queen Bee dress has been made using old clothes, egg carton, and is the creation of a young woman from Avondale College. And when designing the dress, Mariah Herman was thinking about the important role the queen bee plays in the pollination of flowers and plants so that our gardens can be abundant with life. This garment is being modelled by fellow Avondale College student Melanie Nicol. The beautiful queen bee, everybody. Well done, Melanie. Not entirely sure she's enjoying their modelling. Beautiful. Amazing. Okay. This piece was designed and made by Avalon Hutching and modelled by Ashley Cuff. The dress is made using nude fabric, ferns and other flowers and greenery. It relates to the theme by its materials. The materials are what you would normally find in your backyard. Mother Earth, everybody. Thank you. I can use a banana split dress worn by... Oh, is it Summer? Summer, you're wearing it. Also Summer. Which was created by Nufu, April, and Lua Lima from Otakun College. Awesome. The main features are the banana-shaped package spine, along with a variety of prints, fruit, vegetables, potato, printed on the hand-sewn dress. This is a glorious colour showing off the classic fruits and vegetables, which are all items you would find in your New Zealand backyard. Awesome work, Summer. High five. Okay, Jessie everybody, power plant. This garment is designed by Wei Xian and Sunjana from Botany Downs Secondary College. It's inspired by the surroundings of their garden. They wanted to include as many natural items as possible in the creation of this outfit, as a homage to the power of nature. They have used flax, vegetables, plants, and soil to create this wonderful item. And Jessie's done an awesome job in modelling. That's a great walk, awesome walk, Jessie. Next up, let's go. Strut your stuff. Okay, flower dress from Avondale College, created by two teenagers who collaborated on this unique dress. Tale and Stabler have used black plastic rubbish bags as the base for this creation, to which they have attached black flowers, plastic flowers to represent the flower bed. Awesome. And another amazing walk. Well done, thank you. Alright, you'll be alright. Off you go, you'll be fine. Tina Mature from Otahoo College is wearing a fancy table setting to inspire people to think it looks real and alive. This table features two meal settings created from everyday items in the garden. Curly potatoes which have been lovingly cut and dried in the shape of a rose. Items collected from the high tide on the beach have been dyed to create the illusion of a salad. Very creative. Oranges have been cut on a courgette and other garden greenery drape the table setting. It's a very, very inspired outfit. Well done, Tina. This is Pacifica setting. Doing a great job. Are you about to lose your dinner on the table? Okay. A honey of an idea, everybody. Modeled by Jayla. This outfit has been wittingly titled A Honey of an Idea and is the creation of Avondale College student Lucy Parkinson. The skirt has been constructed from pipe insulation covered in layers of paper mache. It is joined with wire before being sprayed with shimmering gold paint. The bodice has also been constructed using paper mache and has a lace detail at the back. It is decorated with a garden theme. This outfit's inspiration came from the massive impact that the bees have on the human population. It is said that bees are responsible for 1 in 3 bites of food that we eat. And the general public is now only beginning to realise that we need to make some drastic changes to our farming and gardening methods, otherwise we may take the foods for granted that they will disappear. Well done, thank you. Okay, sensational watermelon. Woo! Kaisa from Otahoo College is wearing a watermelon dress. This extraordinary dress depicts the watermelon and is inspired by turning the watermelon into something very special. So here you have walking in front of you is a creation which is evolved by Diane Flocks using fabric paint. Repurposed materials such as the lava and apricot stones collected from the jam being made in the school food technology room. So again, all very sustainable stuff going on here. I wonder what the jam tasted like. veggies from your garden before you do. Have no fear, because the ground beetle is here to save you. 445 species of the ground beetle are found in New Zealand, from which 409 are native. This predator feasts on pests so that we can feast on our veggies. The garment is created by Pukekohe Christian School student Lianna Shaw and is modelled quite ably by your leader. The three sections of the beetle are shown in corresponding parts of the model's body. The upper back is the thorax, the lower back is the abdomen, and the head is the head. The bottom of the skirt is a planter box with veggies to show the beetle's habitat. The bodies and the back section of the garment are made from paper mache and garbage bags to replicate the leathery skin of the beetle. Every element of the garment has been made of recycled materials such as wood from the old fence, calico fabric, an old project, and pole firing salvage from furniture stores. The point of the garment is to show an appreciation for the ground beetle. And again, ably modelled by you. Thank you so much.
with the Secondary Schools Merits Award. So the merit goes to number 51, Botany Down School, Avalon Hutching, Year 9, for their Mother Earth piece. So number 51, Botany Downs. In third place, number 56, Avondale College, Lewis Parkinson, Year 10. The judges said, highlighting an important topical subject with great stage presence. A honey of an idea, it says here. Second place for the secondary schools, for the high schools, number 49, Botany Downs, which included Ashley Dolden, Jennifer Davis, Kate Brooks, Robert Rains, Roshni Amihar, Talia Hazelwood, Live and Picnic. The judges said, repurposed materials and construction. Nice to sight on me. Highlighting the importance of family and food together, using the symbolism of a picnic table. And the winner of the secondary school section for 2017, number 58, Pukekohe Christian, Lianna Shaw. Conceptual theory very strong, creative link of beetle and planter box. And therefore garden to table, great innovative use of materials. Third year on the trot for the secondary school section. Well done, Pukekohe Christian School. Let me just have a huge round of applause for our guests, Stella Cattle, Craig McLean, and Bill Cashmore. Thank you so much. Fantastic. I'd also really like to mention the judges. We had Joseph Kalan from the Second Nature Trust